from a new book called What Happened Inside the Bush White House and What's Wrong with Washington, Scott McClellan said the following. The most powerful leader in the world called upon me to speak on his behalf and help restore credibility he lost amid the failure to find weapons of mass destruction in Iraq. So I stood at the White House briefing room podium in front of the glare of the clay lights for the better part of 2 weeks and publicly exonerated two of the senior most aides in the White House, Karl Rove and Scooter Libby. There was one problem. It was not true. I had unknowingly passed along false information, and five of the highest ranking officials in the administration were involved in my doing so. Rove, Libby, the vice president, the president's chief of staff, and the president himself.
I've gotten a couple of emails from Scott since that became public. He anticipated to be made public early next year.
Yeah. And the book comes out in April.
Yeah, and basically saying this is already being misinterpreted and spun in a different way. So I'm going to wait and reserve judgment until I see the entire excerpt. I'm also a little bit restrained in what I can say about the Wilson Plame affair because there's a civil lawsuit. Already lost at the lower court level that they filed, but they've appealed it to the circuit court. And so I'm restraining what I can say. But I can say, and it's on the public record, that Scott's, if this is what Scott said, and I don't know whether it is or it isn't, I'm going to restrain myself.
Did he say it was or was not? I mean, it's out there. It's only one paragraph.
Well, he said it's already been misinterpreted, and there is a more full disclosure of what was said and how it was said and so forth. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to wait for that fuller disclosure. But the fact of the matter is that I told Scott something that was absolutely true, and it's been borne out by the facts. I did not knowingly disclose the identity or name of a CIA agent, and if I had, the outcome of the whole investigation would have been different.
You made innumerable, since that issue is up, innumerable appearances before a grand jury.
Right.
Does that change you in any way?
A little bit, yeah, sure. It makes you more aware of the power of the state. And it also makes you very respectful of very smart lawyers who understand the law and understand how the process and can give you clear and careful guidance, which I had. I had an extraordinarily able lawyer who understood the process. And again, I'm restraining what I can say about it. I intend to address this in a book at the appropriate time. But, people will be surprised at what the process was all focused on.
All right.
It was clearly not focused on revealing the name of Valerie Wilson Plame. In fact, we know today that the person who revealed the name was Undersecretary of State Richard Armitage. And Armitage did not receive the press attention nor the enthusiasm of the mob for his indictment, as seemingly I did. And I guess that had to do with the two different natures of our personalities and the roles that we played in Washington.
How would you characterize those?
Well, I was the guy involved in the 2000 and the 2004 campaign. I'm the Republican Democrats, love to hate. And Armitage is the skillful inside Washington operator who, as we now know, told Robert Novak all about Valerie Wilson, and because he's got that cordial relationship in Washington, is seen as a consummate insider, and as not a Paul, Washington had a different attitude about
it. Is that unfair?
No, it's just what it is. I mean, it's, nothing is, lots of things in life are unfair, but a lot of things are just what they are, and that's just what it is.
As John Kennedy famously said, some men go to war, some don't. Life is unfair.
Right, right. Okay.